Hey, you there?
Yes, I am.
Sweet.
Oh, right.
Yeah, yeah. You'll want to get your ears on.
Yep.
Cool. So yeah, I just posted the announcement that we're live.
Just kind of gonna
let people possibly filter in at some point.
Ooh. Or you know.
Or not. mean, you know, however whatever happens.
Oh, come on, man. We all know you guys have tons of fans.
Yeah.
Yeah. We have upwards of 12.
Yeah.
And I'm one of them.
Yeah. Now, let's see, how am I going to test this? I know how. Here we go. It's convenient having headphones that just have the jack in them. Whoa!
You said jack.
Because I can plug it right into my tablet and just check the stream from there and make sure that your audio is coming through. Because we have it muted on our end. Because otherwise it would echo a whole bunch. Let me just do this.
If I may say, I really do want to say thank you for allowing me to be on your show tonight.
Dude, it's cool.
I'm just saying it.
You just say it. What? What are you?
What?
What? I don't know.
I just want to say thanks.
No, it's cool. It's cool.
Okay. I'm getting that it works. You are coming through just fine. I'm getting my audio back in so I can hear you again.
Oh, okay. That's okay.
Yeah, yeah
that's you were like giving me a weird look, and I'm just like, what?
I knew what was happening. shoot. Okay. All right. All right, I'm back.
Got it. All right. Got it.
All right. So, yeah, you made a checkers game?
Yes, I did, actually. I made an Atari 2600 style checkers game.
Nice. Damn.
Well, the source code file is only 7 kilobytes, so if I could transport it... Well, transport, that's the wrong term.
Yeah.
Transfer it over into assembly. it will fit on an Atari 2600 cartridge.
Nice.
Hopefully.
Cool.
Thank you.
Yeah, nothing I made would ever fit on anything like that.
Well, it's quite interesting because I don't know if you guys know who Scott Adams is, right?
No.
I was thinking Douglas Adams, the author, but.
Well, I sent it to Scott Adams, who I'm friends with, the guy who made Adventureland, The Count, all those.
Oh, okay, really cool, yeah.
Text adventure games, and he said it's good. It just needs AI. So
yeah,
that'd
be cool.
Face with it. Cause I guess I gotta start working on that.
Yeah, that AI has always been like incredibly difficult. Like, if you've seen any of, like, the games I made, the AI always boils down to just walk towards you.
Oh, I've seen them.
Yeah.
Like, hey, they're enjoyable. I love them.
Oh, thanks. They're a lot more enjoyable to watch me play than to play them yourself, I would imagine. But...
I enjoy watching those videos. I find them to be quite entertaining.
Oh,
especially with the pickup sticks one. I think that was that.
Oh, jeez.
I thought the pickup sticks one was pretty funny.
Where oh, the birds? Image. Yeah. Yeah, that was a school project, even.
Yeah, I recall you saying that, actually.
And it's not like it was a school project from, like, 92. It was a school project from 2005.
Nothing wrong with that.
But, you know, it was all on XP, so people could still even run it.
Ooh. That's back when computing was a lot of fun with XP.
Yeah.
Well, think about it like this, though. You could play Land of the Dead on XP, no problem.
Yeah, that's true. Like that was the gaming platform forever, so.
That's true.
How do I do? Also, I'm going to send you this. I can figure out how to do it. There we go. Should be a link to Google Drive. Let me know if that works.
I just clicked it. And now it's opening.
Sweet. That is all my stuff.
Ooh.
Like source code and all.
Holy shit. Part of my language.
No. Go ahead. This is a family show. We're not allowed to say such... What was the... Like, we're the people who said B-hole juice. You're fine.
Then why do you have the guy who made Hanford's Adventure, The Quest for Cats on your show? With that really awesome Renegade trailer. You know, I'm kind of bummed out by that because I was really hoping people would sign the petition to get Hanford's Quest, Hanford's Adventure, The Quest for Cats on Nintendo Switch.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, I was hoping it would create like a shockwave and Nintendo would be like, oh, let's put this game on our piece of shit system. You know, you got Gingerbread Ninja for the
Ninja
Wii.
Bread Man.
Yeah, Ninja Jesus. Bread Man. And all those stupid M&M racing games, you can't...
M&M Racing's the shit.
Sure.
No, okay. No. I mean, in as far as comedy goes, you know, like it's not good.
I would say, honestly, all those stupid Nintendo games with animals and babies.
Yeah.
I would say M&M Racing is way better than those games, in my opinion.
Yeah. Yeah, the plug and play stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh, Mega Man's on here.
Yep. I pretty much everything I wanted to keep, I put on it.
See, or I find it anything. To be a shame that you never went forward with Mega Man.
I think I did as much as I could figure out.
Because that one screen of animation blew the DOS versions out of the water.
Really? Well, dude, Capcom couldn't do any better than that?
Well, this is
where
my nerd side comes out. This is where my nerd side comes out. But it was high tech that made the DOS versions of Mega Man.
Okay. All right, so it's just some other guy.
Sorry, I ruined the show.
No, it's... Yeah, like that's cool.
I'm going to go put my hand on the stove now. I'm kidding.
I knew you were kidding.
Okay. I thought the other guy was like all scared and serious and whatnot.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, definitely.
I mean, always for a number of reasons.
I'm dangerous.
Yeah. It's like being locked in a cage with an angry grizzly bear, I got to tell you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'd say that's accurate.
Yeah.
Sounds erotic.
Oh, it's also very much so, yes.
Oh, lordy.
So, also, have you, you know, we're still in kind of the pre-show thing.
Oh, okay.
But have you seen any of the Basement Quality story time, like the comics?
Yes. Okay. Yes, I have.
Because the Secret Class of Ninja, I was watching that today, just... for memory's sake, and that kind of killed me. It was great.
Goddamn.
You know, I love the story times. I find those to be extremely hilarious.
Yeah.
But I do love the dating simulators more.
Oh, God.
Especially with the owls.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, the owls were good.
Now, is that a real game?
Yes, that's
yes,
real.
It is.
So people play it and masturbate to try to pick up owls.
Yeah. Oh, of course. Well, I mean, probably.
Yes. Is it, yes.
Maybe. Is it a Japanese game? Maybe it's like. Yeah. Maybe it's like purely a joke, but I don't think so.
Yeah, I mean that would be putting a lot of faith in like humanity and stuff.
I'm telling you, ever since that Fukushima radiation, those people haven't been the same since.
Yeah.
Have so, I crossed the line by saying that?
Nah.
Perfect.
Don't speak poorly of the most glorious island nation of Nippon.
How dare you? We all know the glorious nation of North Korea is way better than Nippon.
Oh, shit.
Ooh. Oh, boy. Also, I believe I have, like, the DOSBox window open, like, okay. on the stream. Like, okay, it's showing through. And, I'm just seeing how well this works. I haven't, like...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Ghetto is on. Oh, also, I should give you a link to the stream itself, right?
That would be appreciated.
Like, I haven't even done that. Whoops. I'm still getting used to this. I haven't been, like, live since Christmas. And before that, since, like, 2 years ago with, like, Five Nights at Freddy's. So I'm kind of struggling to figure things out still.
That's all good. You guys notice that, like, Five Nights at Freddy's became, like, the Saved by the Bell of horror games?
Totally. Like me and Taha have, like... Oh,
sorry. No, you guys go ahead.
Okay, like me and Todd have talked a lot about that, about how it's like such a like. I'll just say it, whorey franchise. Yeah. They're fucking whores, is what they are. Just like how they're pushing it like that, and like not like 2 months goes by before the next one's out, and then there's like an offshoot here, and then there's the keychain, the T-shirt, the flamethrower, the everything. And it's crazy.
Those sons of a bitches ripped me off. I was the one that flooding the video game market with my shit. I say that because...
They ripped me off because I'm the first person who started chasing kids at Chuck E. Cheese.
That was you?
Of course, every day.
I say that because I went to my the bookstore with my wife. And I saw, like, flipping through, like, some books. I pretend to read to look cool, but I can't. I saw a book for Five Nights at Freddy's. Somebody made, like, a novelization of one of the games.
Yeah. I heard about that, I think.
Yeah. I don't think many people who play Five Nights at Freddy's have the ability to read.
Yeah.
Have you seen the one video of, like, all the kids singing the... Fazbear song at the same time?
I got a word for that, but I don't think your stream would allow me to say it. To describe those kids.
Well, is it like a racial slur or what?
No, it's a derogatory term for someone's sexual orientation.
Oh, got it. Yeah, you can say retarded too. That works.
Okay, those kids singing that song to a video game, I find that to be very high levels of retardation.
Yeah, I'd agree. Alright, so, I'll close that out. Let's jump to it here.
Okay, what are we jumping to?
Checkers.
Oh, dear God. Are we playing against each other on checkers, or...?
Oh, I was thinking we'd start with, like, me and Nathan, or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
But can you see it, by the way? Like,
let me see. It was your QBasic game, and now the screen's black.
Okay. Wait, that toggles it? Fuck. Okay. It's good to know.
I hope you guys like the checkers, because...
Okay.
I was bored one day. And I made this game in, like, 3 hours.
Cool. Nice.
I
could send you the source code. Just keep it between you and I, because, you know, I don't believe in sharing source code.
Okay. I do, but...
No. There's a reason why. There's a community that I make fans with. They're like, hey, why don't you show your source code? And I told them to fuck off.
Yeah. Okay. Like is that QB64?
Yeah.
Ah. Gotcha. All right. So I'll be red, and we'll just pass the thing back and forth.
All right.
Is it actually more direct if I just share the screen? Can I do that? do I do that?
Beats me.
That's good cranberry juice. I have to stay regular. I'm sorry.
No, yeah, not totally. No.
I'm 57 years old. God. I'm not actually 57. I don't know why I said that.
No, you don't sound a day over 47.
Thank you. It's all the smoking I used to do.
Yeah.
Honestly, I'm like getting to where I can say I'm pushing 30, and that scares the shit out of me. And it probably shouldn't.
Oh, shoot. Just one second. Okay. I need to grab something.
Okay. Alright. I'm bad at checkers.
It's fine.
So sorry about that. I had to grab my...
Oh, shit.
Okay.
Are you hearing Skype fucking up?
Yeah, I think it'll stabilize in a second.
Okay.
Maybe not.
Am I fading out of existence?
Yeah, a bit ago. Yeah. You seem to be okay now. It's still showing red, though.
Well, that's good.
But, yeah. Okay, so... We got the game. Do everything in your power to not press F2.
Okay.
And
that's unfortunate because F2 is my favorite button.
Yeah. I'll just start out with 3-3 and go to 4-4.
All right.
It's functional. It does the things you say.
All right.
To do.
Have you guys played this game before?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I've played checkers growing up.
No. I mean my version of checkers.
Oh no.
I think I tested it a little bit, like for the stream, but not extensively.
Ooh, okay. This is gonna be fun.
Okay, so he's doing row 6 and column 4, and it's not letting him do it.
Yeah.
Oh, it's only single moves.
Well, I mean, like, he's trying to select 6 and 4.
Oh.
Like, he's green, and...
Eight. Two? Yeah, I'm not able to select anything.
Gosh darn it. Now I'm embarrassed, you guys.
There we go.
Okay, we got something.
Oh, okay, sweet. My self-esteem has risen.
but yeah, I don't think he selected the one he wished to select, so you know, that...
And that. Now I can't move where I want to move.
Uh-oh.
What the fuck?
Well, I don't know what to say, you guys. I apologize.
No, it's all good.
No worries.
I remember there was a recent RPG that I played where, like... Oh, yeah, it was one of Colin's games, actually. But it was on my engine where, like, if the enemy was at zero... No, if your health was at zero...
You just won.
You just win, even though, like, you're supposed to have died at that point.
If you don't go below zero, you just can't lose the game at that point.
Yeah. Huh. Like, until you're healed, you have a free pass to win every battle.
Nice.
It was pretty great.
You gotta tell me about this Colin guy.
He's a real smart dude.
Yeah.
He was 13 at the time. He made, like, Glancer and stuff. And now he works at a real game place, right?
No.
No?
He works for Epic, like, doing hospital software stuff.
Oh, okay. I thought it was Epic Games.
No.
Okay. Then I'm wrong about that, but... But yeah, he was a math major.
Oh,
super, yeah.
Super great at it too.
Yeah,
fancy. He's a good guy.
All And so you're just kind of stuck at 6'8"?
Yeah.
Maybe
it's...
Here. Let me open up a game here, and I'll check to see what's matter.
Okay.
Let's see. Do some on the spot troubleshooting.
Sounds good.
Okay.
In the meantime.
You changed all their names to be their actual names.
Oh no, I have two versions.
Oh, gotcha.
Like, one was the one I thought Bandai Namco would, like, come after me.
Yeah.
Like they would throw a cease and desist on me.
Nope.
That's... also, there's an energize button. Press S, and that refills your Dragon Ball Z energy.
Oh, thank God, you guys are playing something else.
Oh yeah, we're just filling the time.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah. Also, you can press left and right at the character select to like switch between like. So you can play as the other guys. What an assault on the ears.
Yeah. Alright, I figured out the grand strategy for this game is just to
just press buttons really fast?
No, just run up to him and hold the kick button.
Yep, that works too. Also grand strategy, power up to full, unleash all your Kamehamehas immediately, and then do that.
Gotcha.
Because you can just like... take them down to where you won't have to keep doing that.
Yeah.
You know, this reminds me of that Atari 2600 game, Karate.
Yeah.
It's awesome. I love it.
I played Kung Fu on NES, but like I haven't actually played Karate for the Atari.
It's absolute garbage, punch. But this game makes it. This game shines above it.
Super Saiyan Gohan just getting punched in the face by Cell from across the universe.
Yep.
Dragon Ball Super sucks. I actually never owned an Atari.
You poor bastard.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Wait, you never owned an Atari, so what was your first video game system?
NES. Nintendo.
Ah, gotcha. Nothing wrong with that.
Also, you have no chance to win. System. Yeah, that would be unfortunate. Like, remember... oh my god, my ears. like, Taha, like, when he was a kid, left the NES on, like, all the time, and it caught fire eventually.
Damn.
And so his mom just would not have Nintendo products in the house. So he kind of grew up as a Sega kid. Like, which... is unfortunate, but... Not really. Sega had good stuff, but Master System was kind of weak.
Master System was awful. You guys ever see Mortal Kombat on that?
I didn't know it had Mortal Kombat.
Yeah, it has Mortal Kombat, dude.
Wow. I know they had it on the Genesis, but...
Oh, yeah.
I didn't know they had it on the Master System.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. Same with Sonic the Hedgehog.
Yeah, I remember they had Sonic pretty early. And it wasn't nearly as impressive. As the later games.
Well, no. But then again, what really is, right?
Right.
Yeah, those games were the shit. Until they went the one way with it.
Yeah, Yeah, and don't forget all the furries too.
Yeah.
You ever notice with furries, it's always like fat, unattractive men?
That's not entirely true. There are plenty of fat, unattractive women who are furries too. I used to hang out with a few, and not counting Randy here, but like other people, were they were hard to be around.
Oh yes, yep.
Oh man, I can only imagine.
Oh. Well, they weren't like in furry character all the time, but they were like kind of just like that all the time enough to be off-putting.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And they were all older than me, so I couldn't really tell them they were wrong or anything. Because, wrong is not really what I'm going for, but like
made a lot of bad life choices.
What?
Yeah, I just used my extendo arm.
You just used Trunks' extendo arm to punch Goku in the face?
Yeah, repeatedly.
Okay, cool. Yeah, it's, they would be like, I has it! I can does it! And, you know, they would talk in mannerisms like that, and that just grinds on my soul a little bit.
Yeah.
Like, it just gets to the center of me so much quicker than other things.
Oh, same here. One time I was playing laser tag with my friends. Don't judge me on that, because I think...
Laser tag's shit.
Sorry?
I like laser tag. Or I would if I played it. I like
laser tag too, don't get me wrong, but I'm not going to go around bragging about laser tag. But...
Yeah. Sure.
We went to this birthday party, I guess. Like, this girl was having a party, and she was like, oh, let's go play laser tag. And we were like, okay, so you go play laser tag, and it's us against this team, this other group, and this other group's a bunch of furries. And they're wearing, like, foxtails, and one dressed up as an animal.
Oh, and one's in, like, the full thing?
Yeah, but here's the thing, though, right? Like, the room was so humid and muggy, the arena that we were playing in. So yeah. we were fucking sweating our asses off. I don't know how this person was able to survive without collapsing and dying of a heat stroke or something.
Yeah, jeez. Yeah, me and Taha go to conventions every so often.
Mm-hmm.
I guess you do too, but you go to different ones.
Yeah, I do like tabletop gaming conventions.
Me and Taha are like insane awesome people who go to anime conventions. And, that's kind of a big furry ground.
Yeah.
Where a lot of that occurs.
What was your most awkward moment? Or should I say, where you felt the most embarrassment for another human being?
Whew. You know, like, you'd think it would be something I would just remember, but, like, I don't all the time.
I mean...
Like it's something I try not to think about, because...
Well, I mean, you're, like, the cringe connoisseur, so...
I am. But, like, when I'm there...
Yeah.
When I'm in it, it's a little different, I guess, but see, the cringiest furry moment of my dealing with furry moment of my life. It would have to be Drew and his posse at some point.
Oh God, yeah.
I guess that one's a bit personal. Not for me. Well, yeah, they're like, I guess that was cringe for a different reason, just because, like, real shit was going on.
Yeah.
Embarrassment, though, is pretty much any time someone whips out a fursuit, I'm always like, okay. Okay. I don't want to be here anymore.
Yeah.
There was the one video. This is like a video. It wasn't something I was there for. It's the one with the Attack on Titan thing.
Oh, God.
Like, oh, it's a part where a person's getting eaten by a giant thing, and this person's getting, like, devoured whole by it, and there's just a face cam in the corner of a furry in full fursuit who looks like he's masturbating or something, I can't really tell, and is just going,
God,
like,
damn.
The whole time.
Yikes.
And it is just, like, beaten off to this thing.
Yeah.
That one, like, I remember I was just kind of watching it like this, like, oh, okay. Because I needed to get through the whole thing, because that was, like, the challenge.
Yeah.
is to sit through the whole thing. It's not even a formal challenge, it's just, like, I was like, I believe in myself, and I believe I can sit through this.
And people died on D-Day so that man could wear a furry suit.
I did 2 tours in Vietnam!
I got shrapnel on my head for Charlie. I learned to love it.
Yeah,
and here you are masturbating to anime porn in a suit that looks like a dog.
Yeah. I should take you up back and shoot you like a dog. But Dad, it's my inner animal creature.
Oh God, I do like the Bobby Hill voice. Yeah.
But Dad,
but Dad.
No, shut the hell up!
Damn it, Bobby.
Oh, also, for the games I release to you, they will require DOSBox.
Well, that's fine. I got DOSBox.
Cool, cool. And they'll also require the CPU cycles to be max. Like in the settings.
Oh, sorry, you cut out there for a second.
Oh, it'll also require the CPU cycles to be maxed out.
Ooh, okay.
Just because they go so unbelievably slow otherwise.
Yeah.
Like, unplayably slow.
You gotta love that, eh?
No, that's strategic mode, man.
Yeah.
Every movement is planned.
Well, thank you for giving me the inside scoop.
Yeah, no problem. I was actually going to release them publicly. Like, I was actually going to do it before, but I didn't yet.
Oh, you
no, no real reason. I just didn't.
Man, that was good cake.
Nice. I'm eating an Aldi Hot Pocket right now. I am not living it up.
Believe me, where I'm at, it's not living it up, actually. I make it sound
cool.
Yeah,
you're at camp, right?
Yes, I am. And not the cool camp, the bad camp.
Not the salute your shorts kind of camp, but like the...
Yeah, it's not the cool camp where, you know, you go across the... You know, you got that one camp counselor that all the guys want to, you know, quotation marks, get with. It's the kind of camp where everybody's depressed.
I see.
Meatballs lied to me is all I gotta say.
Yeah.
Fuck, I'm old.
What sounds good?
Ooh, you know, you should play Ghetto.
Alright.
Yeah, yeah.
Oops. Yeah, that's right. It's its own directory.
Man, I miss the old days of DOS.
Yeah.
Well, the funny thing is, I actually built a computer. Well, I didn't build it. I stole a bunch of pieces and put it together. So I built a computer.
Yep.
And I, like, found this old hard drive. I wiped it out. I installed Windows 7.1 on it. It was
7.1? 3.1 or...
No, it was like DOS 7.1.
Oh, DOS 7.1. Okay.
Let me tell you something, you know, when people say, you know, sex is better, they're totally lying. Installing DOS 7.1, it's fucking mind-blowing.
I remember, like when I was growing up, I was, like, super young. My dad brought home a computer from his work. And, like, it had, like, a graphical interface called Gold.
Mm-hmm.
And it just, like, you could set up launchers to certain programs and you can just click on the side. But, like, that was, like, a super expensive thing that, like, only, like, luxury business people got. And it's, like, such a, like, useless thing almost. Because, like, they also had Windows, which is, like, that only, like, every, like, click on anything is, like, a launcher for something.
Mm-hmm.
And Gold was just, like, a bunch of buttons on the side that you associate with an executable file. Then you click that and it runs that.
Ooh.
Or a command. And, like, that's all it was, really.
Nice.
And you'd, like, start in DOS and either type gold.exe or just win.exe and to start up whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, yeah, it was kind of a interesting time. Like, I got to learn the DOS prompts real early, so I, like, understood command line interfaces a little bit.
Hey, that's awesome, man.
Then I moved to Windows and forgot it all. I was actually super shitty with computers up until, like, I turned 15.
Oh no. That's terrible, man. I was great with computers when I was in, like, grade 5.
Nice.
Not to rub it in or anything.
Like, no, it's totally cool.
I'm not one of those guys. Hey, I got a question for you about Ghetto.
Sure.
Who are you shooting?
Everybody.
Well, those little sprites are the ninja sprites from the ninja game.
Yes. And there's a prostitute with money?
Yes. There's a prostitute with money that you can just take because it's implied that you're the pimp. And, like, the people running away from you are just, like, citizens. Most of them are brown, but there's one white one. And then you see blue ones coming after you.
Mm-hmm.
That's a 5-0.
Gotcha.
That happens after your body count gets over 20, I believe.
I wasted all my bullets.
Oh, press enter. Once you get to, like, $50, you can press enter to buy, like, 50 more bullets.
Gotcha.
Then you can do it again, because you have enough.
Sick.
This is an awesome game, dude.
Yeah, I was pretty impressed by it. Like, the guy, like, I was talking to, we'll call him Dr. Scumbag. he kind of, like, helped me make a lot of these games.
Mm-hmm.
And, He was Kenji from Digital Swordsman.
Nice.
sort of. But, he was playing San Andreas, and he was like, I really want you to make a San Andreas game.
Yeah.
So I was like, okay. Because, like, he had gone on vacation for, like, a week or two. Like, one or mm-hmm. 2 weeks or something. Like, to Australia for, like, school or whatever. And I had learned how to do a lot of stuff in that time. Because the last thing he saw me make was Secret Class of Ninjas, the text-based one.
Right.
And then, so he was like, wow, you're really coming along with all this text-based stuff. And then he, like, leaves, and I make color. That, like, paint program kind of looking game.
Mm-hmm.
And then I took that knowledge and applied it to the ninja game, you know, the kill every ninja.
Yeah.
And so he comes back, and I've made this now. This "You Killed Takeyatsu" game.
Yeah.
That was just super, super anime. And he was like, "Oh shit!" And then he like leaves for like a day or two, comes back playing GTA. He's like, "I want you to make San Andreas," and I'm like, "All right, I'm gonna try it." And so that's. So then I made Ghetto, and I was trying to make it, like, super edgy, and at the time I was super Christian kid, and, I thought just putting weed there was like, whoa, you don't do that. And so, like, that's why the weed is the health item in this game.
Oh, and, no.
Yeah. Little did I know, it actually has medicinal effects.
not the devil's lettuce.
Yeah, exactly. I was that kid, though. I was, like, really opposed to any kind of drug, really opposed of any kind of sex on TV or whatever. Just because, like, you know, I was incredibly Catholic at the time. Like, obnoxiously so.
I'm glad you're not anymore.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
Ruined my life a little bit, but at the time. Luckily, I was in high school, so I didn't have much going on anyway. But, you can buy another case of bullets.
Oh, shit, I picked up even more money.
Yeah. And so I was, like, going against pretty much everything I believed in making this game. Like, I didn't really care much for violence, because, like, being American and... What? Why won't he die?
I don't know.
Try going one up. Okay. Being American, like, sex and drugs is wrong, but violence is awesome.
Yeah.
And violence I didn't really even bat an eye at. Like, murdering of police is, like, fine. But but when it came to, like, showing...
Look, they're just trying to infringe upon your Second Amendment rights.
Yeah, exactly. And... Yeah, so, like, I put a hose with money that you're a pimp for, and, like, weed on the screen, and I was like, oh, this is going against everything I believe. This is great. That's how Ghetto happened. It's basically San Andreas with me being, like, super, like, indignant about it the whole time.
Yeah.
Nice. I have a similar story, where, you know, I made a whole shit ton of text adventures.
Yeah.
And I met this guy named Walt. Oh, shit, I shouldn't have said his name.
He's been on our, like, zombie adventure.
Yeah, like, I'm just going to call him All-American Hero.
Mm-hmm.
So All-American Hero was like, hey, you know, what's your next thing you're going to do? And I told him about, you know, zombie adventure. Well, I suck with graphics. He's the brain behind all the graphics and, like, the, you know, digital display and stuff like that. I came up with the story and shit. And Ooh. So we made Zombie Adventure together, which I think is a fucking breath
Don't
of fresh air.
Don't leave the screen yet. Sorry. Since his body count's over 100, there is a white ninja that's faster and does more damage. That's the Marine Corps, like the National Guard coming after you.
Oh, shit.
Okay, so continue.
Okay. And so we made Zombie Adventure, which is still happening.
Nice.
I don't want to give too much away about it, but it is going to be quite epic. Almost as epic as Donald Trump being president. You know, that brings a tear to my eye. For all the right reasons.
Yeah.
But, you know, then I started making, you know, more text adventures and roguelikes and made that checkers game, and here I am today, sitting in a room in an unknown, disclosed location.
Nice.
Yeah, some would say undisclosable.
Tell it to my heart, mister.
They'll never find me.
Oh, it's actually quite funny, because every once in a while I'll go on, like, these forums, and I'll be like, you know, oh no, I can't
Shit!
I'm only here for a short period of time, but here's something I made, and tell my wife and kids I love them. And then I went on this, like, this QBasic 64 chat, and so people were like, "Hey, is this Dave? Is this Dave?" And I'm like, "No, no, I'm Frank Stallone."
I am Jonathan
Frax
Taylor Thomas. Shit.
Yes. And so like I was like, "No, I'm not David, but." Play 2600 checkers, and they're like, "No, that's not for me," and I call them lame. But I'm not Dave.
Nice.
Hey. Oh.
This is Ninja. It's basically Zelda, but shitty.
Oh, yeah. It's like the new open world Zelda.
Yeah, it's just like Breath of the Wild.
Yeah.
Breath of the Wild. Is that a good game?
Yeah. Yeah, it's super good.
What's up with everybody saying dad ass in that one scene? Isn't like Zelda like 12 years old?
I mean, why would that stop anybody on the internet?
Yeah.
That's true.
You're talking to people who played dating sims for a month. I don't know what people think anymore.
No, I have to ask, what was the weirdest? Because I've seen all your dating sim videos. I love the fact that people masturbate. Well
yeah, me too, man.
Simulators, because it's good for the human race to have them spill their seed and not impregnate women. But what was the worst dating sim that you guys ever played? Like, hands down, like the most awkward.
Oh, jeez.
Disgusting game you've ever played where you're like, I'm done.
I think that would have probably, for me, had to go to the fucking Rape Dragon from fucking Morinatsu this year.
Yeah, Morinatsu was a very strong one this year. If it was this year, Morinatsu would take the cake. I'm trying to, like, remember the whole spectrum of everything. In fact, I'm gonna go ahead and just look through our list to
check
see if there's
anything I suppressed. Date night playlist.
Yeah, I'm gonna look at the date night playlist and just see if there's, like, a memory I've suppressed. Because I'm certain there is.
No, the funny thing is, I was away from my wife on Valentine's Day. And I want you to know.
Well, I'm glad that we were here for you.
I've never ejaculated such a larger load in my life. Thank you.
We got your back.
Why, thank you. I'm glad. I'm glad I'm not making this awkward for you guys.
No, not at all, man. It just brings a tear to my eye.
Let's see. View channel.
Trying to use YouTube mobile here.
Ah, yeah.
Because I don't do that enough. Oh, shit. We need to play Aviary Attorney again.
Oh, shit, yeah.
That game was fun. I remember, like, the first one we played, the Always Remember Me from, like, forever ago.
Yeah.
I remember how, like, every, like, bitchy and, like, manipulative way to speak to a person was always the right answer.
Yeah.
And, like, I don't know, that was bad. The free dating sim, I think, was also really bad.
Yeah.
Because it was, like, based on art from an anime that didn't exist yet, and they just made, like, the most, like, painful story they could.
Yeah.
What was the name of the bad guy? It was, like, Dr., like...
Yeah, it was...
Dr., Octo-something?
Dr. Octopus?
Dr. Octopus.
No, wasn't it, like, I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
But yeah, that was a strong one. Oh, God! Gender Bender DNA Twister Extreme.
Oh Jesus.
I think that's the one. That's...
Do people make money off these games?
That one was like $25, I think, or
you didn't
or
pay
more.
For it, did you?
I know my way around the internet, good sir.
Oh, touche.
We'll as to not incriminate myself, I will say money was not left from my bank account for that game. Yeah, that's subtle, right?
Yeah.
Dude, I stole it. I fucking stole it. I fucking stole it from the internet, yes.
I don't think the FBI is going to be knocking on your door and saying, excuse me, sir, did you not pay $25 to this masturbation fantasy porn?
Excuse me, sir, did you download one Gender Bender DNA Twister Extreme? No. I'm here... I have video evidence of you saying something different. Care to explain? And then I act like to catch a predator after that. I'm like, look, this is not wrong, okay? What I'm doing is fine. What I'm doing isn't hurting anyone.
Yeah. I just came here to talk and get her some alcohol, you know, because I know what it's like not having friends and not being able to drink at 13.
Yeah, exactly.
These cookies are really good.
Yeah.
So where's the other guy?
Taha's at work still.
Yeah.
Nerd.
Right?
What a nerd.
What are you doing?
I don't know.
You can press enter, I think. Or no. Backspace again?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That's the button.
He might be off work now. I can ask him if he wants to, like, show up
for yeah.
this. Oops, that's not the app that I need to be opening to do the thing that I'm trying to do. But first, I'll get video footage on the screen.
You just leave it on the screen for a while. Like, I feel like people really respond to that.
I like it.
Yeah.
Now, you guys, you know, I have to leave in like an hour. I hope that's okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
Shit.
Because we got man.
Oh, it's such a big problem.
I'm sorry.
Damn.
We got like a recording session tonight. Probably, I got some bad shit.
Oh, you guys are in a band?
No, bad shit.
Oh, bad shit. Okay, sorry. I'm sorry, I didn't know you're into drinking the devil's juice.
Yeah, no. I wouldn't drink the devil's juice. Well, yeah, I would.
So what do you guys want to talk about?
The devil's juice, I suppose.
No, how about the devil's juice? What the hell are you talking about devil's jizz for?
Nothing. No reason.
No reason.
how about that irate gamer, eh?
Oh, man. The irate gamer is so angry.
He's really edgy, and he says all the words I want to say in public, but I'm too ashamed to say them.
But I'm too ashamed to say them. It's all the things I want to say, but I'm too ashamed.
Remember when that guy was, like, popular and he was, like, a YouTube puppet? Remember those days?
I remember, like, I actually got in on the ground floor on Angry Video Game Nerd, so, like, I was one of the first, like, actually, I was a little earlier than, like, Angry Video Game Nerd came out, and he was, like, a smash hit and all that, and then, like, there were all these other guys, like, Armake21 at the time, there was some girl named Bukitty at some point.
I remember those days.
Yeah, like, I consumed the shit out of that kind of stuff. And, like a Ryuken from Dingo, am I right?
Yeah.
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 I consumed the shit out of that, but then, like, there was a big controversy among all those people, because people kept calling them ripoffs of the Angry Video Game Nerd, and they didn't like that. And, like, they were like, we provide our own style. We're not ripoffs. We do our own thing. And, like, it was a whole issue. But then, this irate gamer came out, and he started just saying the exact same things the angry video game nerd would say.
Yeah.
Like, he even used the words shitload of fuck a lot.
Yeah.
And, yeah, he was just, there was no question that this guy was a ripoff. And, like, I couldn't even be a white knight for this guy, because it just sucked too much.
Yeah.
And he was so wooden and so fucking, like, it was just the corporate version of the AVGN.
Yeah.
You remember?
Really hope that, like, ass load of fuck was a bullet point in, like, a meeting.
Yeah. Like, they have it on a bulletin board pointing at it with a laser pointer, and they're like, no, here, this ass load of fuck right here.
Yeah.
Sell. Is this really good for the company?
I heard the kids on the street, my son was telling me, says ass load of fuck. Can we use that? That's hip.
Yeah.
It's almost as bad as when I was like looking up YouTubers, and I don't know if you guys ever seen this guy. It's called the Game Boy Reviewer.
Game Boy Reviewer.
Yeah, he was like 2007. He would like review only Game Boy games.
I'm surprised I didn't see it, honestly.
Hmm. He was a tender little feller, let's just say that. Do you guys like Sonic Chew?
Oh, Jesus. Okay. Are we opening up that box?
Well, I don't
Taha
know.
Has more things to say about the legend that is Chris Chan.
Well, I don't know what to talk about, you guys. Like, my assistant didn't give me any notes.
No.
I'm flying my private jet. I'm doing this show with you guys before I go to New York City. Like, come on. Give me something.
Sonichu is deep levels of shit. And I'm finding... I recently discovered Lucas Werner. And he's, like, kind of Diet Chris Chan, I find.
Is he trying Chris to Chan light.
No. He's desperately trying to get laid with someone under 26 years old. Well, he's like 37 or something. And he insists that they have to be like that. And that, like...
You know, because of telomerase.
Yeah, I'm getting to the telomerase.
God.
And he believes that if someone under 26 has sex with the girl also under 26, they are creating some, like... Because he's not even saying, like, they have this with longer telomeres. It's just that they say they get longer telomeres, which he believes is, like...
And that's linked to the same kind of like stuff. I don't know.
Yeah, I can't follow what he's even talking about. But he's saying that like it can lead to cancer, and so it should be banned, like child porn, basically.
Yeah. God.
It is a deep rabbit hole.
My God, what have you guys subjected yourselves to?
Do you know Daniel Songer?
Oh, man.
Daniel Songer? No, I don't.
He's the greatest.
I'm going to assume he's not the greatest.
He is, though.
Oh, man. Just press 00 and it'll show the list. I mean, 0.0. He's basically a comedian who is the worst, and he has that Carlos Mencia style of delivering it.
Oh, God.
Where he's just very loud and obnoxious, and he just, like, starts randomly singing in the middle of his bits.
Does he also pretend to be a race that he's not? Just to be famous?
Oh, and no.
He's called out by Joe Rogan and loses it all?
He doesn't do that. He's way white. Like way white.
Yeah.
And often almost naked. And, like, big. In all the worst ways.
So you're telling me he's gonna watch his penis hole out every night or else he gets infected?
No. I said, in all the worst ways. I'm pretty sure his dick is nothing to write home about.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Engulfed in his flap.
Hold on. I gotta link him up here.
Yeah.
Oh, dear God.
Yes, and try to get through the whole thing if you can. I understand if you can't.
Like I said this one time at a party, and I was hoping everybody would join in.
Yeah.
And I said, let's do it. And, you know, I drove a quad through a fence. Nobody else did it. If that makes any sense.
I think it does.
All right, let's watch this.
He has like hundreds of these videos.
Yeah. Like that is awful, like what you're about to watch. But then I found out that he has like 400 of those. Whole 400 videos that are that.
Yeah.
Is he doing this in an abandoned parking lot of like a park that's been shut down for the winter?
Something like that. Like,
I hope so. I hope he's not doing it in places where there are children or people around.
Judging by this guy, I honestly think what he does is he scouts out locations, and then like he goes there when everybody's at school and work because he's embarrassed.
Yeah. Like if he gets like the sidelong look of a woman, he'll just like clam up and leave.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I imagine he does this at like family get-togethers and like family reunions, and if people are like, "Hey, Dan, just stop. Just stop. It's not funny." And he'll just like be depressed and put on like a big show and like ruin it for everyone.
Yeah.
You know the funny thing is, I see the complete opposite.
Okay.
Where like he works like in an office for an insurance company, and he's just like everyday Joe. Like he's married, has three kids, and you know, people are like, "Hey, what did you do on your weekend?" He's like, "Oh, I just took the kids fishing, and that's it." But he doesn't. God, this video is terrible. But I see him like so ashamed of this. He doesn't talk about it. And it's one of those things that when he dies, somebody at his job would be like, "Hey, man, you know Dan? He was a poet. And he's doing all these stupid things on YouTube." He's like, "What? Let me see." Like, that's the kind of thing. Or it could be the other way, where like he gets really angry, beats up his wife, drinks a half a bottle of Wild Turkey, and goes in the parking lot and makes these videos. I'm leaning more towards the guy, the shy, timid guy who was big in high school. And then wound up like Al Bundy.
Yeah.
You know, but instead of shoes, he's like selling car insurance.
I see him as being divorced. Like she just could not like take it anymore, and she bounced the fuck out, and he's just like making this to stay sane, and like he's just. Like, trying to sell it every day. Like, he's not allowed to see the kids anymore. And just, like, all that.
I'm reading the comments on the video. One guy says he's taking the divorce really hard. So, somebody else wrote, "Dad, please come back home." Another one says his kids probably fucking hate him. Coming at you live from a dilapidated car park in Ukraine.
Oh god, it's so funny.
Where is this?
Knows what it's like to be shot in the eye, man. Sure does.
I like to think that this guy doesn't like show people these videos.
Yeah.
He just makes them for his own amusement because he thinks he's really funny. Like, he thinks dad jokes are hilarious, but he wants to take it to the retarded drunk uncle phase. and it doesn't end well. And I bet you anything, like, one day he'll stop suddenly and this channel will be gone because somebody would be like, hey, Dan, I saw your YouTube.
And then it's gone. He just nukes it all.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, no.
Oh, wow, this guy's defending him. And then somebody else is like, wrote like a fucking poem. Oh, wow. It's like a fucking paragraph defending him.
Damn.
All right.
Man.
Did...
condom smile, you know.
Yeah,
it's worth defending, I'll tell you that. Yeah. There are battles to choose, and this is one of them.
It's not bad, it's before its time.
Humanity would be wiped out. Aliens will find like this old server or like a new generation, and his videos are the ones that survived.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just shiny condom smile. It would be amazing. They'd be like, hey, can we bring him back? Yeah, this guy's really great. He made these videos. He made these things. These recordings of him. And we don't know how he did it, but he's so great. So let's bring him back.
and then they just fucking restructure this guy, and, like, they learn everything. So there's just a big, like society of aliens who are just like, come on, feel the heat, girl, slam my meat. And they all are just laughing at that.
You put too much effort in that.
Oh no, that video is hard. Wait. That's hard mode Daniel Songer.
Yeah. That's actually a video? I thought you just made it up on the spot.
Oh no.
I wish that was just me, but it's not.
he probably masturbates to Taylor Swift then. Because that's the kind of thing, you know.
Yeah,
Probably like, you know, she probably resembles that cheerleader in high school. Let's face it, he was in special ed. And, probably. You know, that's the cheerleader in high school that he remembers. And this is his revenge, is just masturbating to pictures of Taylor Swift and letting them fester in the sun.
Just letting it dry up and burn like it's invisible ink or something.
Or he puts them in mason jars and puts them in the fridge in the garage. And then he's like, my children.
It's like, my children.
My children. Zap to the extreme.
I do like the idea of him just being, like, Jeffrey Dahmer of some kind.
You know, I could see him being, like, a pastor at a church. You know.
I can see that, too. Like, his
perverse,
oh, man.
Lyrics out of the way.
That's so good. Yeah. He's like a youth group pastor.
Yeah. and, like, he does this. He's like, this is my little more, like, loose side for when, you know, when I'm not in the... when I'm not on stage, you know, I'm hip, I can have fun.
And then at the end of the day, he goes home and he's like, now I've completed my day. Because let's face it, like the guy looks lame. Like, the guy's that kind of guy at work that he's like, hey, everybody, how's it going? And everyone's like, oh, good, Dan, good, you know.
Yeah, he's kind of like the manager who's always like, hey, how you doing there? All right, cool. You're doing great. You should respect my authority at any point in the day. All right, bye.
And he always tries to be nice to, like, ethnic people, so, you know, he seems like he's progressive.
Yeah.
Like, he's the kind of guy that'd be like, you know, yeah, my friend Tony, you know. But
I was like, oh, yeah, I love brown people. My friend is brown. Fuck.
There's that one black guy who's, like, sort of his friend, but he doesn't have the heart to tell him to go the fuck away.
Yeah. He's just like, oh, I'm the only one of those that he has. It's just exactly what he says. Oh, shit. We are midstream.
Oh, fuck.
Come on in, bruh. We are on Skype with the one and only.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
It's the realists. Where's the... Where are the...
they're in that drawer. They're kind of in the back. Oh, I only got the small one because all the other ones got ripped apart.
And, shit. Oh, that's right, because they're like...
Because, yeah.
They're all doing some weird thing. Some weird thing.
Yeah, Taha just got here.
Hey, Taha. Soup.
He'll be in audio in a second.
Oh, God, I embarrassed myself.
Oh, you're... Chill, it's gonna be all right. Oh, sweet.
Yeah, we were talking about Daniel Songer.
Oh, God. Oh, that man is... I don't think he knows, like, that what he's doing...
I don't think so.
...is not hilarious.
No, that's wrong, you guys. It is hilarious. It's too weird to live, too rare to die.
Yeah. It's very true. It is just too weird to live. I just love that Daniel Songer likes to stand in the woods and do that.
Like, yeah.
He shouts his stand-up routine loudly in the woods. So, like, some unfortunate joggers and, like, people mowing their lawn and, like, I don't know, police officers are just hearing this man destroy his own voice. Choking on the best jokes.
Or women between the ages of 19 and 35 tied up and bound and gagged in a shallow grave.
Yeah.
It's just some mobster dumping a body. It's like, hey, that joke wasn't funny.
Wait a minute.
Is someone being hurt right now? Why need to stop doing all this mob work and save someone?
Oh, wait, Dan's doing his routine again. Looks like another hooker's dead.
Don't remember how to rename stuff in DOS. Do you remember what the command was to rename stuff?
No.
Okay.
Here. Let me Google it.
Yeah.
I'm doing a show, man.
we gotta be professionals. We gotta just know how to rename stuff in DOS.
Yeah.
Shit.
Okay. Like here, I got this. Okay, here's an example. I'm gonna send it to you on the Skype. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Well, it's this huge fucking page. Okay, here you go. Cause I'm nice that way.
Awesome. Thank you. Suppose so, I probably so going, just should have.
Oh man, it's going great. I spent today, you know, pleasing myself.
I am you.
Everyone does.
Do you cry afterwards? Because I do.
No, dude. Oh, cool. The jar of salsa I use as lube does. It's crying spicy tears. Por qué picante?
My God, this conversation is taking a turn for the dark. I picture some poor Australian boy who's like 8 years old. He's like, I love basement quality. Oh, they're doing a live stream. I'm going to listen to it. Masturbating with spicy salsa.
I can't wait to try that, mate.
His dad beats him. There's like a...
Dad, son, what you did to the salsa, that is not okay. We do that to Vegemite around here.
Who told you to do those horrible things? I listened to it on the basement quality.
Oh man, I hope we get banned in Australia.
I hope we get an angry letter thrown to us from Australia that then returns to Australia.
Like in a sort of a parabola arc.
Yeah, sort of like
tensions are higher with Australia afterwards, more so than North Korea.
If we're ever bombing Australia, that's gonna be an interesting time.
Oh, life. Man, yeah. Like, the kangaroos are going to kill us.
You just gotta send, like, a whole fleet to, like, bullfrogs.
Yeah, yeah.
That's like that Simpsons episode where, they, like, Bart brings, like, a bullfrog. And it just ruins the environment.
You call them bullfrogs? I call them chazwazes.
Just chazwazes? Yeah. That's not a knife. This is a knife. That's a spoon. Ah, see, you played knife and spoony before.
I would love to go to Australia and try that.
I just, like, I, like, super, like, I legit actually always wanted to go to Australia because, like, I was, like, obsessed with the crocodile hunter. When I was younger, like, just, like, I loved that shit. I loved watching this crazy man run up to a crocodile, grapple it, and then show us its genitals for no reason. Like, I remember every time he did that, I always questioned, why do you gotta do the last part? You're just supposed to relocate that thing. It's like, we gotta relocate some crocs that have found themselves in trouble areas. It's like, oh, okay, Steve, cool. That sounds like a really cool thing you can do. And you're wrestling it? Holy crap, you're strong. Then he just flips it over. And he's like, look, it's a female. It's like, what the fuck? Steve, why are you doing that? Is this not okay? He's just a problem crocodile. You don't got to show us his dick.
I don't have to see his dick. Well, go ahead.
I always wanted a fucking Australian woman just so I could hear her sound like Crocodile D and say, like, oi. Fuck me harder, mate. Fuck me harder.
It's just like that episode of Rocco's Modern Life where he's like working at a sex phone like thing. And he's just like, he just gets on the phone. Oh, shit. Oh, baby. And you hear that like large hippo woman just go, oh, dang. Yeah. I love that show so much.
God.
Like, I think because of Rocco's Modern Life and also the Crocodile Hunter, I just want to go to Australia and just, like, just see the things that made those things and hopefully not die from them.
Yeah, yeah.
My favorite Crocodile Hunter bit was on this episode. He was, like, holding a snake, and the snake bit him. And then it cuts to him, like, on, like, looking at a book on the hood of his Jeep, and he's like, all right, not poisonous.
Yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah.
And he's like, all right. He was crazy. There was an episode where he goes to the Komodo Islands, and he purposely goes to a dock that no one uses anymore because Komodo dragons just are chilling, waiting for people to eat.
Yeah.
And he just goes there, gets out of his little dinghy, and just, like, books it. These, like, huge, like, thunder lizards are trying to murder him, and he gets up this, like, rickety old tree, and one of them bites through his shoe and fills his shoe with venom.
Oh, jeez.
His shoe was filled with their bacteria, like, venom.
Oh, God.
And he was like, oh, that was close. That could have hit my heel. That would have been dead. If I had any cuts or anything on my feet, I could be dead. Yeah. Like, dude, what?
That guy reminds me of Bear Grylls and the fucking, like, if I wait anymore, I'll die of anaphylactic shock.
Oh my god, yeah. That, my favorite Bear Grylls moment ever, besides the part where he ate bear shit for real on cam.
Oh, damn.
My other favorite thing besides that time was when Bear Grylls was, like, it was in the Badlands, like, in, I don't know where it was in the U.S. This is a place called the Badlands. It's, like, this really bad...
I'm in there.
Yeah, it's this really, like...
I don't remember where it was.
I don't remember what state it's in, but, like, he was there, and there's, like, nothing to eat, and there's no people for, like, miles and miles and miles and miles, and there's, like, no water, nothing. And he's out there, and he finds, like, a bee's nest, right? So he's like, all right, I'll light a fire and smoke the bees out so they get calmed down, and then I can just, like, go and steal their honey. And I'm sitting here like, well, you know, that'll, like... Okay, and then he does it, and then it's like the wind blows the smoke in a straight line, not even towards the bees, and you can see this on camera. He doesn't even acknowledge it. He acts like it's working. Then he just walks up there with his shirt tied around his face, like that's going to stop the bees from stinging his face,
yeah,
and the rest of his body, which is now exposed. And he goes up to the bee's nest, and he starts cutting off pieces of the hive to eat the comb. He's eating the comb standing there while they're stinging him, and he runs away from the bees, and they leave him alone after a couple, like... After a few feet, they actually leave him alone because they don't give a crap about him. And then his face swells up, and I'm not even shitting you, his face looks like Nala from, like, The Lion King. It looks like a lioness. That's how big his nose got. And his eyes were so closed with like a cat face. And oh, he's just damn. Like, and he just is walking through the desert. I just love hearing his voice going, if I don't find shelter soon, I could die of anaphylactic shock. And I'm like, that's because you just ran up to a bee's nest with not calmed down bees and then just pissed them off. You just shook their hive around and just started drinking their honey. Like, you stupid idiot.
Also, Taha, did you need an Aeon?
Yeah, I do need an Aeon.
Okay, cool, because I got a Shiva right here.
Oh, sweet. Yeah. I need some of that good Shiva. Yeah. What? I'm not even reading the screen, sorry.
This is that one game where people are just like, go ahead, take these magical beings.
Yeah,
yeah, just, I don't give a shit about it. It was that one where I was like doing that really high-pitched shrill voice, which got us a lot of dislikes for all the right reasons.
Yeah.
All the dislikes for all the right reasons. Like, that one is hard to sit through for that reason.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, cool.
I don't know who the hell would dislike you guys. You guys are way funnier than Amy Schumer.
Yeah. You said that like you read that on a piece of paper in front of you.
Wow, that really hits home. Yeah.
My assistant just came in the room, sorry. I was trying to be sincere. It's the only thing written on this sheet of paper.
I was waiting for the teleprompter to update, but there are no words on it!
It's just an ASCII middle finger going slowly up.
I'm Goat Shitter. Who are you?
Yeah. Well, clearly the wrong person. Because they're going to kill you, I guess, now.
Yeah, well, yeah, he's got to kill me because I'm there. I'm in the room with him. Like, you can't be in the room with a human being.
No. Yeah, it's like, it's just, you just can't do that. Like,
if any one of you, this also goes for you, David, if any one of you was in the room with me, I would kill you on sight.
Oh, okay.
That's fair.
Cool. Good thing I'm not really here.
Yeah, it's, well, wait, shit, you are kind of in the room with me, aren't you?
I was going to grab, there is a knife with peanut butter on it. I looked right at it when you said that.
Because I did too. One of us is getting peanut butter.
I made him into a peanut sandwich. Why not any jelly? The blood was the jelly.
Oh shit, now I gotta fight Bahamut.
Oh, well, yeah.
Guess I'll just die.
Neo Bahamut.
Darn. Also, my use of darn, because I didn't want to swear in any one of my games, is just the best.
Replacement swear words are like 10 times funnier when you grow up.
Yeah. Because they have no weight to them at all. It's just like darn. Like,
aw, gee whiz.
That point in Secret Class of Ninjas where it's like, we always lose the best of us.
Darn. 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 Ah, man.
Oh my god, it kills me.
That is so funny. It's so funny. Like, I really would love to see, like somebody make a, like, short comic of, like, the stuff you, like, wrote. Like, like, when you were younger. Like, just all the weird, like, spelling errors and, like, and, like, weird grammar stuff just all still in.
Yeah.
I'd pay to read that.
Like, I would pay for that.
I would charge to have people read that.
I would pay Pat for to read that.
It should be.
I would pay people to read that.
I would pay Pat to read his own thing.
It should be between two characters, like an Australian kid, like the one from The Simpsons, and Pat.
Yeah.
Crudely photoshopped together.
It's great because like your like tag was Dingo forever. Like,
it still is.
Oh, yeah, I guess it is. Like
I'm Dingo on everything I'm not Pat on.
Yeah. So, like to the outsiders looking at us, realize how, like, Australian you must seem to people because of the Dingo thing.
Yeah.
Before you, like, totally. Talk to them. Like,
Yeah. Fucking Derek Dingo.
God. Damn.
I love that Derek Dingo, like, I legit would try to pitch that as a cartoon to, like, Nickelodeon or something, like just this weird thing that's always doing finger guns and won't fucking stop it. Cause like there's like so many good like weird surreal jokes at that idea.
oh, you know what you guys got to do? Take one of those Soviet era cartoons from the 60s, take out all the dialogue, and put all the dialogue from your game.
Oh, man. But Kenji, you have free will. How could he make you kill Ferris? Yeah, yeah. I don't want to risk what he's got up his sleeve.
Well, like that idea, you can take, like,
I'm okay. Opening the portal now. Yeah,
yeah. What was the name of that, like, there's, like, this, like, cartoon that, like, made famous, that, like, form of animation where you don't animate a mouth. You take a photo, like, you take a chroma keyed mouth,
an actual mouth,
and
talking.
Then put it on their face. I don't remember what the name of that show was, but yeah. If you, like, took episodes of that and just, like, forced, like, dialogue from your thing in there, like, that would be the best. Just force Ishtaria into that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Goddamn Ishtaria.
I just pictured some Australian kid. What did I ever do to these assholes?
He just drops his Vegemite. He's like, ah, oh, bloody Chanda. Man, I wish it, like, we had had the Let's Play channel back when I, like, played the entirety of Taz the Tasmanian Tiger. Not Taz the Tasmanian Tiger. What was the name of that? Like, Ty the Tasmanian Tiger. Taz is a Tasmanian Devil. Yeah, there's like a game, there's like this, it's like one of those rip-off, like, 3D platformer type deals, kind of like a Jack and Daxter. And it's like, it's like this Tasmanian Tiger dude, and I remember when I played that game, I just had, like, the incredible urge to just, like, try to, like, spit out as much Australian slang while I played it. So, like, anytime I got a collectible that was, like, the end of the game collectible type of thing, like, you get, like, a power star type of deal. I don't remember what the collectibles were, but every time I did, I would just, like, be like, oh, blimey, struth! Like, just have, like, a list of, like, Australian slang and of, like, big document, and then just read it.
Yeah.
Like, I wish I had recorded that. I was just doing it in front of, like, two people. It's really great.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, these?
I remember these. Do you remember
these?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah.
It'd be like great if
these are bad.
Yeah, they're
are some that are good, but largely they're bad. The good thing is I never stopped trying to be funny like I did in Derek Dingo.
Yeah.
But the bad thing is I rarely was funny.
It's pretty amazing.
What this is, David, I started a sprite comic. Like, this is kind of... This was about the same time I was making the Dark Basic game, so it was after, like, all the QBasic and all the other, like, drawn comics.
All right.
And I dedicated myself to making one of these a day.
Oh, shit.
And sometimes I had no ideas, but I had to make one before I went to bed. It was just a thing. I had to do it. It was like a creative thing. I had to make something.
You just don't remember, like, the entity that was, like, removing your memories and forcing you to do this, or would kill you before bedtime. You're just like... Before the green thing showed us mercy, We had to make a sprite comic every night before bed, even though we didn't want to. And it was hard, because jokes were impossible with the green thing in the room.
Yeah.
Let's see if I can find the worst one.
Is it just a copy-paste of Lost from Control Delete? That would be amazing.
No, it's just a single frame. That's just the worst thing I've ever said ever. Yeah, it's this one.
Yeah, that one.
Yeah, that one's it.
Yeah,
like that. God.
It's like so little context. Like now. Like,
no, even then. Like this was just one of the strips on one of the days.
It just showed up. It's just like this sprite.
This is today's comic, guys. Bye.
Yeah.
And do you know what it was about?
What?
Not what? You know, anything to do with rape or anything. But what it was. Was I had a pirated Windows XP at the time.
Uh-oh.
And they just rolled out WGA, which is, you know, the Windows Genuine thing.
Yeah.
So it was a big, like, thing that would constantly show up saying, hey, your Windows is not genuine, and all this stuff. And you couldn't really get rid of it until people figured out how to.
Yeah.
And it was just this thing that I had to deal with every day, and I was so upset about it because, you know, me stealing this thing is such an injustice against me.
Yeah. And,
because, like, somehow I made those mental leaps to think that Microsoft is hurting me somehow.
Yeah.
And, like, how dare you protect your own software?
Yeah.
That you made.
And like, I was an interesting kid. But, yeah. But, like, yeah, like, so I made this as protest, and I was like, yeah, that's gonna get them talking.
Just like mail
Microsoft
that,
is gonna give a shit.
Just like, tweet that at Bill Gates now.
Yeah.
Like now in 2017, and he's, like, not even the CEO anymore. He's just kidding. Yeah. So it's just like, okay, I don't know what they did, but all right.
You know, it would be funnier if you put Paul Hogan's face on that little black character's body.
Yeah.
Holding a spoon.
Oh, man. Oh, yeah, and for some reason, all of, like, generic people were just Sniper Joe.
Yeah.
From Mega Man 7.
This is like, all these Sniper Joes walking around with their big-ass shields and their, and their guns for arms. They can't peel a banana. They can't use a baseball bat. They can't brush their teeth because they don't have teeth. They have a helmet instead.
Do you remember when you were walking around the community college and you'd see all the people, all the other fellow students walking around going, "Halt, citizen! Yeah. Present your shield!"
Yeah. Oh my god. I would have loved it if, like, in real life, when you grow up, you just become RoboCops. Oh, everyone just becomes a RoboCop. So all adults are just like, "Stop, child! Please present child identification. Here you go."
Oh yeah.
It's like, this is not sufficient.
Nathan was in this.
Yeah.
And this is him.
That's
this
me saying Sonic sucks.
Yeah.
Fuck you.
Sonic sucks.
Like Sonic.
That was not even something I said.
That, like, makes it even better. Well, you're saying it to Colin.
Oh, man.
Who has a DND
t-shirt. Oh, shit!
On. That is so...
That's Colin.
That is exactly what Colin looks like. Actually, if you wanted to know anything about Colin...
That's everything you need to know.
That is all of it. That's 100%.
He's this dude who walks around, like, in an amorphous shape. And just kind of has, like, butter for hair. And he's always kind of grimacing. And he also likes D&D.
Yep.
He looks Mormon in that picture.
Imagine this stopping to your house and just be like, "We are the soldiers of the army of the church of Jesus Christ."
Like, I love how mushy. Why is Nathan so huge?
Yeah, like, I never made him any smaller. Like, I just gave him the biggest thing, and I'm like, yeah, he'll just be bigger than everybody else.
I also love the blaster he has.
Well, I mean, it's just because you were trying to go for accuracy rather than, like, making me fit into the aesthetic of your comic, which was probably a mistake, but...
Yeah.
I am actually that tall relative to other people, so...
That's like... Oh my god, I remember that, like, there was a lot of gamer jokes at this time. Like, Hito hated FPSs, but I loved them. He didn't even like MMORPGs, but I'm like, yeah, well, fuck you. And I just strawmanned him as the guy who likes everything I hate.
Yeah.
You just, like, you gotta, like, send this to him now.
Yeah.
And just say, "Take, eat shit, fucker."
No, just say, "Take that."
No, send, like, a snap of you doing that. Like, to him. I don't know if he's the person who has Snapchat, but
I'm not a person who has it, but I can be a person who has it.
Just to annoy Colin.
Strategy over action. Action over strategy. And then I kill him, and it's, "You fragged Hito, you limp." God, I want to die.
Oh, shit.
I want to drive off a cliff.
You fragged Hito, you
limp. So then he says, Sonic sucks, but me and Colin both agree on that, so we're gonna murder you because you have an opinion that's not ours.
Yeah. I mean, it's pretty close to how the climate of like gaming culture is though. Like now even.
Yeah.
It's just like, how dare you like something that I don't.
But this
like.
Is such a fucking control delete
joke. Oh yeah, it is.
Well, this totally predates Gamergate. You were onto something, man.
Yeah.
Once the gamer gate was opened, all the demons came out. I hooked up a PlayStation to a 32X and a Sega CD and also a, like, I don't know, the that RAM chip from the N64. I stuck them all together and it just like opened the gamer gate.
Yep.
Then a whole bunch of Blood Rains and also like Kratos came out and had sex with everyone till they died.
Yeah.
Oh, so Gamergate was the edgiest characters ever.
Yeah.
I'm looking at these and man.
It was definitely about integrity and journalism.
Yeah.
Not some fat woman that slept with a couple guys.
One time.
Yeah.
Listen, we all do things when we're desperate to get laid, all right? Judging from those guys, they probably are very desperate.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I mean, they're somehow involved Phil in something Fish. Called Gamergate. Oh, God, Phil
Fish. Phil Fish is one of them, allegedly.
God.
Yeah, that's a great one.
I like how, you're peeing from, your hand.
Yeah.
The stream is if the sensor bar was moved, it seemed like the stream is coming from your hand.
I also like the fact that the sensor bar comes all the way up to here.
Yeah.
So I'm just hung like two donkeys.
Yeah. Or you've got two average sized dicks going in both directions. Yeah. Like some kind of dick copter. Some kind of tails. The box of dicks. I'm sure I'm not the first one to think of that. And that's definitely on TV.
Oh, yeah. My dad's just Dr. Wily.
Oh, man.
Is your dad Dr.
He is, though.
God, no, not any more of this.
I love the I just ate, three or four warheads at once, reaction you have whenever you said.
No, I think this hurts more than anything else.
No.
The only other thing that hurts more is the Secret Class of Ninjas shower scene.
That's pretty bad.
That is the worst.
That is pretty bad.
That is the most embarrassing thing I've ever done. But this is close.
I don't know, you had a guy with a butt for a face poop out of his mouth.
That was funny. That was pretty funny. That was good. That was good shit. Oh yeah, and we made a personification of the internet, and he looks like that.
Okay. That makes sense. That's what the internet looks like. One big beefy arm for good measure.
Yep.
And a big
good consummate V's. He's got consummate V's.
It's just a big angry monster.
There's a little bit more snake to him, more S to him. He'd be a strong
guy. Shooting Colin again.
Yeah.
Over God knows what.
You're just reading is just assuming you just hated Colin.
Yeah, that wasn't even it. It was just we had a disagreement about video games and I was like, yes. Content for my comic forever.
I had this one guy on the bus. He said that he didn't like Jigglypuff in Smash. And I said, you're going to be in a Sprite comic, buddy.
I had Pink Eye one day, so that was today's strip.
Oh, man.
It was just that.
I have a Pink Eye.
Sweet. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, that's it.
These
are amazing. How much content there is from that time period.
How long were you doing this?
It went on for about a year, and then I got super self conscious, and then I stopped doing it, and then I picked it back up, and it actually was pretty funny after that. But I only made a few.
Yeah,
but they were pretty good though. There was this one. The one with,
Do
you remember,
this one's some of my favorite things. There was a
product that used to be advertised late at night on Comedy Central called Extends.
Yeah.
And it's, what you think it is. It's, a male enhancement.
But it makes your snake bigger.
Yeah. But they would always come on and we were like, they'd call it, it was like, hey, if you want to enhance that certain part of the male body, and stuff, and then this woman comes on, it's like, oh, like building more muscles? And then he's like, no, no, honey.
Male no, dipshit.
No, I'm making my dick big so I can slay you down.
And they talked about, like, major university, double-blind studies, as if, like, that would be like, wow, that's like, a big word.
Yeah, you're just saying a lot of things that sound
and it's
like
wow, that's a big word. These guys know what they're talking about.
It's like sneaking into a place by wearing, like, a safety vest.
Yeah, exactly.
He's like, oh, man, I'm wearing this safety vest. He's probably supposed to be here. Just let him through.
Yeah. But
for the participants, those chewables.
Those chewable vitamins gave me a huge boner for 4 hours. I don't know if that's normal, doctor. But my erection lasted for 4 hours.
So here's how this one starts. You want a bigger that certain part of the male body? A few years ago, we didn't have massive schlong technology. We had missile defense system, but no wiener pills. And then the woman comes on and is like, that's because the key ingredients is proven in cock stens is proven to work with real science. Yeah. That was something she said in the commercial. Was just like, it's not a gimmick. It's real science.
Yeah. Like, they're trying to sell you on, like, the, like, science of it. Like, when you're eating dick pills, I don't think you're going to sell someone with science.
Yeah. Well, no, but that's like, it's like, dick pills are just a scam. They're like, no, we have real science to back up our fake dick pill.
Yeah, I guess so.
So then he's just like, hi, I'm a super credible doctor, and I have personally that was another one. There's like a doctor.
Yeah, he's personally.
He's like, I've personally researched extents. So like, he's like, I've personally researched.
He like fed them to a chimpanzee.
If you catch my drift, bam, nailed it!
I just like to imagine that the guy like was just feeding them to a monkey, and the monkey was just like getting mad at him.
Yeah,
and he's just throwing like poop at him. Like, he's just like, this is really working on this monkey.
The narrative behind it is he's jacking off a monkey every day, and he's like, wow, this really works.
This monkey never loses his boner, no matter how many times I jack it off.
I still got spunk on my jacket coat here.
Yeah.
I just can't stop watching this monkey masturbate.
Man, I gave it some of this extends, and this monkey just won't stop masturbating. Wow. You think it's the extends or that he's a monkey? Nah, it's gotta be the extends.
Yeah.
Science. We will send you a free sample, but we will not pay for stamps. We're not made of money here.
We're not giving these penis pills away for free, you know.
If we weren't so confident in our product, do you think we could afford to give away free samples?
Yes.
They have claimed to, like, have sold 100 million capsules.
Sure. To, like, one guy.
Yeah, yeah.
And this is that scenario. What you got there? You know, male enhancement. Oh, like building more muscles? Okay, hon. I love you, but if you open your trap one more time, I'm gonna snap you in the cunt.
That shit, like, killed me for, like, decades.
Goddamn.
Like, I still think that's fucking hilarious.
Well, you guys, I hate to say it, but I have to get some sleep.
Ah, right. Shit.
Take care.
All right. Hey, this was fun. You guys should invite me on sometime again.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely, yeah.
It'd be great. And once you get Checkers up and running, like to give that a go again.
Yeah, definitely, man, definitely. Hey, you guys have a good night, and thanks for having me on.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. Thanks for being on and everything. Thanks for all the games and everything.
Oh,
yeah. No problem. Yeah. See you guys.
See ya.
Bye. Peace.
Bye.
That guy's pretty cool. Swag. Yeah.
Oh, god damn. Oh, shit.
Here's a good
one.
This is pretty good.
I just like...
I'm going to take a... large.
Oh, man.
Greasy. Oozing.
Shit.
Oh, man. Fucking.
It's
wait,
like the,
was that Jack Thompson?
Yeah, that was Jack
Thompson. Yeah, dude.
Oh my god, I forgot him. I forget about him every day. Every time you guys say him, I remember.
Every day I forget about
Every day I forget about Jack Thompson. I forget about the Thompson every day.
Oh god. I fucking loved that toy. Like, my fucking uncle got it for me. My mom was super pissed. Yeah, the Flankinator.
Yeah. That is like the 90s toy. Like,
it's time for a flaky, greasy, oozing scab.
I love that, like, the 90s was the time that, like, don't play with a regular boring toy. Play with one that also vomits and shits on you. Yeah. Or just looks like lots of boogers.
Yeah. You can and go to officedepot.com/make slime.
Let's make slime.
Make a gag for your sister.
Oh, man.
Yeah, put it in your sister's hair. She'll never get laid. It's like some weird shit with that. Like, that was like the marketing for Du Bois toys. Like girls' toys was like always baby or mother related, but then little boys' toys in the 90s was either like just a G.I. Joe, just like a hyper violent thing, or super gross.
Yeah, use this to harass your sister.
And like, yeah, and you as a weapon against your sister to not have a boyfriend for some reason.
Yeah.
Like, it was just great because, like, that's like a perfect marketing cycle, because, like, the marketing was to get girls to get boyfriends.
Yeah.
With their journals and diaries.
Yeah.
And then the marketing for the boys was to get rid of those boyfriends so they would be in a constant boyfriend loop. So they have to keep buying new ways to scare boyfriends.
Would just be like, oh, your brother came in with, like fart powder. Oh, we're through.
You know, even better than that is if there was like a girl gets a boyfriend who's like into like the old school like the kids like gross out toys.
Yeah,
and he brings his own like yak back and starts fucking with his sister. like he hangs out with little brothers. Like, my girlfriend is dumb. Let's make her fart, and she doesn't even know she's farting. Yeah. It's like, hey, Katie, want some beans? Oh yeah, okay. Just eating it, it's like, yeah, it was like, it's like,
got him.
We got you. Now you're gotten. She's like, well, guess I have to break up with you. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Sounds well, that's right. The end.
Guess that's the end. High five, kid. This 80s like jump and stop in midair.
Yeah, yeah. Oh shit.
Oh, those are the Mega Man ones. Yeah. I love Mega Man's face when he's, like, in the darkness behind, like, the bad guy. And he, like, has this, like, shit-eating grin. Like,
yeah.
That's the funniest shit to me. Because it's just so... It's just so maniacal looking. And it's just so badly drawn. It just makes it so much funnier. Like, it's like... I'm gonna fuck you up. It's like, oh, God, what is that?
Yeah, yeah.
Why does he want to fuck me up? I don't know what that is. The floating head. Is that the one? Yeah, this is...
I know your ex. Yeah.
I forgot that's what the line was. I remember the line, like, made it even better. Like, it's just like, I know you're here. He's just back there like...
He looks like he should have, like, one twitching eyelid. Like, he's just fucking coked out and, like, crazy.
And, like, is it the fact that he looks so peaceful while he's saying that?
Yeah, the one guy and X is just over there like...
All you gotta do is finish the drawing where he's just eating a bowl of cereal and X is just holding a big-ass, like, knife. He's like, I know you're here, X. Nah. He's like, never get roommates on Craigslist.
It might be a giant robot who can make their own decisions, who might choose to kill you in your sleep or in your awake. Who cares?
Yeah, yeah.
It's like you're just watching like a movie, and like you're watching like I don't know, just like some movie about robots, and like fucking God, it looks like Lil Wayne's mouth.
Lil Wayne's mouth.
It surprisingly looks a lot like Lil Wayne's mouth. Ancient crayon drawings look a lot like Big Lil Wayne's mouth.
God damn.
Was there ever like a... Oh my gosh, you could really shrink that. Okay, never mind. I thought it was gonna go even like smaller till it's like a little speck.
Get that in the middle. No. There.
Shit. What does that do?
Oh god. Alright. But yeah.
Good night, y'all, anyone who may or may not be watching.
Yeah.
Good night.